Dear students, let us start the chapter Area of Parallelograms and Triangles. All of you know about the formula for area of parallelograms and triangles. Here in this chapter, we shall discuss or we will prove some theorems related to area of parallelograms and triangles. So before starting the topic, I want to recall you about congruent figures. All of you know the figures which are equal in shape and size both, they are known as congruent figures. So if two figures are congruent, then their areas are also equal. Here I have taken two triangles, they are congruent to each other. The two parallelograms A and B, they are also congruent to each other. So if A and B are two congruent figures, then area of A is equal to area of B. So, but the converse statement is not true. First statement, we have proved the if the figure A and B are congruent, then their areas are equal. But the converse statement, if two figures have equal area, they need not be congruent. So, here in the second case, T is a planar region here. So T is divided into two non-overlapping regions P and Q. So here the area of the plane region T is equal to area of region P plus area of region Q. Let us discuss about the figures having same base and in between the same parallels. So here I have drawn some figures. Look at the first figure. Here A, B, C, D is a parallelogram and D, E, so this is F, C. D, E, F, C is also a parallelogram. These two parallelograms having same base DC. Here in the second figure, P, Q, R, S is a trapezium and M, N, R, S is a parallelogram. These two figures having the same base SR. Here also in third figure, ABC is a triangle and DBC is also a triangle. These two triangles having the same base BC. But here, so this is our fourth figure. So in this figure, ABCD is a trapezium and EFCD is a parallelogram. These two figures having same base DC, but they are in between the same parallels. Here AF parallel to DC. So these two figures are in same base and in between the same parallels. Here also in figure 5, PQRS is a rectangle and TURS is a parallelogram. These two figures having same base SR and they are in between the same parallels. That means here PU parallel to SR. Here in the figure 6 also ABC is a triangle and DBC is also a triangle. They are having same base BC and they are in between the same parallels. So the last three figures, these figures are in the same base and in between the same parallels. So let us prove a theorem. Parallelograms on the same base and in between the same parallels are equal in area. So here ABCD is a parallelogram and EFCD is a parallelogram. These two parallelograms having same base DC and they are in between the same parallels AF and DC. So this is given. ABCD and EFCD are two parallelograms having same base DC and in between the parallels AF and DC. Then what is to be proved? To prove parallelogram ABCD is equal to area of parallelogram EFCD. Then proof. No construction is required to prove. So here you take these two triangles AED and BFC. In triangle AED and triangle BFC, this angle will be equal to this angle because AD parallel to BC. These are the sides of the parallelogram ABCD, and these two angles are corresponding angle. Angle DAE is equal to angle CBF, corresponding angle. And again, this angle also corresponding to this angle. That means DEA angle, angle DEA is equal to angle CFB. So this is B here. So CFB. So this is also corresponding angle. So this implies by angle sum property of a triangle, the third angle must be equal to third angle. So this implies ADE angle is equal to BCF angle due to angle sum property of triangle. So and AD is equal to BC, opposite sides of a parallelogram. So this implies triangle AED is congruent to triangle BFC by ASA congruence rule. So if two triangles are congruent, then previously I told the two triangles are congruent, that implies their areas are equal. So this implies area of triangle AED is equal to area of triangle BFC. So here I have to add the area of the figure EBCD in both the sides. So add area of the figure EBCD in both sides. So this becomes, so this implies area of triangle AED plus area of the quadrilateral EBCD is equal to area of triangle BFC plus area of quadrilateral EBCD. EBCD. So this implies this is area of triangle AED plus EBCD. AED triangle plus quadrilateral EBCD. That becomes area of parallelogram ABCD will be equal to area of triangle BFC plus EBCD quadrilateral. That is equal to EFCD. Area of EFCD. So this is proved. Example 1. In this figure, ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. EFCD is a rectangle. EFCD is a rectangle, and also AL perpendicular to DC. AL perpendicular to DC. Prove that area of ABCD is equal to area of EFCD, and second, prove that area of ABCD is equal to DC multiplied with AL. So here look at two figures ABCD and EFCD. ABCD is a parallelogram and EFCD is a rectangle. It is given. So they two have the same base BC and they are in between the same parallels. Rectangle is also a parallelogram. So area of here in this figure ABCD, the area of parallelogram ABCD is equal to the area of the rectangle EFCD, because by our previous theorem, the parallelograms having the same base and in between the same parallels are equal in area. So area of ABCD is equal to area of EFCD, because parallelograms having same base and in between the same parallels are equal in area. So here they have same base. ABCD parallelogram and EFCD rectangle have the same base BC and they are in between the parallels EB and DC. So that's why the area of ABCD is equal to area of EFCD. Then second one, area of ABCD is equal to DC multiplied with AF. So we know the formula for area of a rectangle. What is the area of the rectangle EFCD? We know the area of rectangle EFCD is equal to length into breadth. So that is equal to, what is length here? DC. DC is the length and breadth is AL. So this is the area of the rectangle EFCD. So we know area of the rectangle EFCD is equal to area of parallelogram ABCD. So this implies area of ABCD is equal to DC multiplied with AL. Here I have taken AL directly. So it can be, you can write DC multiplied with ED, because ED is the breadth of the rectangle EFDC. So this equal to DC multiplied with AL. As ED is equal to AL. So next example, if a triangle and a parallelogram are on the same base and in between the same parallels, then prove that the area of that triangle is equal to the half of the area of that parallelogram. So here in the figure, ABCD is the parallelogram and PAB is the triangle having same base AB and they are in between the same parallels BC and AB. So triangle PAB and parallelogram ABCD having same base AB and in between the same parallels BC and AB. We have to prove here, to prove area of triangle PAB is equal to half of the area of parallelogram ABCD. So to prove this, we have to construct here, draw BQ parallel to AP. draw BQ parallel to AP. Then proof. So here consider two parallelograms. PABQ is a parallelogram because already it is given that PQ is parallel to AB and we have constructed here BQ is parallel to PA. So the parallelograms P parallelogram, PQBA and parallelogram ABCD having same base AB and in between same parallels PC and AB. So this implies area of PQBA will be equal to area of ABCD according to our previous theorem. So in parallelogram PQBA, PB is the diagonal. We already know diagonal divides a parallelogram into two equal areas. So in case of area of PQBA, we can write that is twice of area of triangle PAB is equal to area of ABCD parallelogram. So this implies area of triangle PAB, so this is triangle, is equal to half of area of ABCD. So this is proved. So in this way, by using the theorem, you can solve any problems.